The Fiji Women's Crisis Center receives 600 calls a month, and of that, 3% are for suicide. Center Coordinator Shamima Ali says FWCC counselors are trained to deal with suicide cases and refer them to relevant agencies.
Over the years that we have seen where the woman has been abandoned, or the woman or she has walked away and the guy is suicidal or the woman is suicidal. So we need to keep a lookout for, you know, and keep a lookout for our children, who they are seeing, what are the relationships like. We should talk about healthy, respectful relationships in our homes, in our communities, to men as well as to women, and keep a lookout on that.
In Fiji, men dominate the number of completed suicide, and Ali says there is lack of services by men for men. She says men often think that seeking help is unmanly, and that needs to change.
Then we also have men, you know, who are accessing our lines, and they're being referred to our male advocates lines. We have got about four or five lines going for men, which we do the referrals to. And they're also, going through financial difficulties, not being able to make ends meet. No support and things like that.
So she adds the stigma around mental health should also stop.
There is too much stigmatization. As soon as you say mental health, you know, the word insane, mad, you know, and things like that. But we also make jokes. If someone is going through something and is showing some emotional distress and so on, we immediately say there's something wrong with her head or his head, you know, and things like that. And it's looked down upon, and people try to distance themselves. They don't understand, you know. So we really need to address this. And, you know, more people who are sort of leaders in our community, respected leaders who have gone through this, they need to come out as role models. Some young people are coming out.
FWCC also called on people to look out for their loved ones, recognize if they are having a hard time, and get help as soon as possible. Mary Onimili, Fiji One News.